Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday, SpaceX successfully launched the Starlink 6-8 mission on a Falcon 9 rocket.
2-1, ignition, liftoff.
The booster which launched this mission, B1078, then landed successfully for the fourth time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 1 landing burn.
There we can see that landing burn has begun. In preparation for touchdown on our drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas.
Landing light deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Beautiful backlit view of that first stage. Falcon 9 first stage has now successfully launched and landed for the fourth time.
Then the following day on Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched the Starlink 620 mission.
2-1, ignition, engines full power, and liftoff of Starlink. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1075, then landed successfully for the fifth time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing burn.
There's confirmation that the stage 1 landing burn has started in preparation for touchdown on our drone ship.
Orbit insertion. Landing light deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
And this Falcon 9 first stage has now successfully launched and landed for its fifth time.
There is another Starlink mission we can hopefully expect to see liftoff in a couple of days. The Starlink 6-9 mission is scheduled for Friday 11th at 1:41 a.m. UTC or tomorrow, Thursday 10th at 9:41 p.m. EDT. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. Another section of Megabay 2 was lifted and installed. Zach Golden posted some information related to work at Starbase on the propellant loading capabilities. He said, as I mentioned would likely happen in the episode linked below, SpaceX is in the process of expanding their propellant loading capability at the orbital tank farm. One additional LOX pump was installed last week and another just arrived a few minutes ago. We likely won't see these operational until after the upcoming launch attempt. With 5 out of 5 LOX pumps, we should expect to see up to 4 additional subcoolers installed as well. 2 of them are already on site. Integrating those into the system is the difficult part and is the reason SpaceX may hold off until after IFT2. All of this is a result of massive electrical infrastructure upgrades allowing SpaceX to drastically increase the amount of power being supplied to the launch complex. Somebody called Jim Free from NASA gave some information recently related to SpaceX and HLS. This post says we are holding all our contractors to December 2025 for Artemis 3. Just got update from SpaceX and digesting it. We'll have update after that. Need propellant transfer uncrewed HLS landing test from them. Spacesuits also on critical path. Could be we fly a different mission. Ship 25 has been removed from the Pad B test mount. Ship 25 was also rolled back to the production site for possible pre-flight preparations. On Sunday, SpaceX performed a static fire test of the Booster 9 prototype.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
They also posted this cool drone footage of the static fire test. This test was so much better than previous tests and the last launch. Pretty much no debris was kicked up compared with previously and the test was a lot cleaner. SpaceX also posted these cool pictures of the Booster 9 static fire. After the static fire testing, Booster 9 was lifted off of the orbital launch mount. As with Ship 25, Booster 9 was also rolled back for possible pre-flight preparations such as the hot staging ring. Once again, I have to say thanks to Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.